I could be serious. And I see that I'm going to have to really be serious. So sad this world is. So people see me express the joy that comes naturally to me, and it's not based on any outward appearance, anything. And people get confused. On some level, I guess I understand why they do. But on another level, it upsets me because I know that most times they are mistaken. And they're really just hurting themselves by thinking that they need to have an outward reason to express joy. Religious people, not the humble ones who have a good heart, no, not those. Those I treasure. I see them as wonderful, beautiful children. You see, these types, they are being exploited the world over, no matter what religion. No matter what religion, man. Not just the Bible. The Bible is a book. For those who have befriended me recently on Facebook from India, it's not just about the Vedas. And the Vedas are also books. If you read about Vyasa, the name Vyasa means scribe. He compiled all these Vedas, all these scripts, all these writs, all these vast material and metaphysical sciences. And he still felt empty inside. And he realized that he had to spread the message, the gospel, the song, beyond the message, the song of the true God's love. Okay? Then you have the atheist types. The atheist types, they like to talk about their super individuality. And most of them, what they are doing is reacting to the corrupt religious figures throughout the ages. They are both wrong. You talk about your individual self-expression. That nothing else matters but what you can prove, what you can manifest. That there is no rhyme or reason to this whole existence. And where does this come from? This comes from many places. Like a hurt little child. We want to promote our own self-importance. And we miss. We want to talk about the void and nothingness. I know that void too well. There is something beyond that void. That void, that black void, is just like that white light. Expressions. These are effects of something that is lying way deep beyond that. Also, my Indian friends, they ask me, how you into our culture, our religion? Listen, if I went to India, 9 times out of 10, I would not be hanging out with the people that you'd be hanging out with, okay? No. And I wouldn't be going there to join an ashram or to be initiated by any guru. This is a fact. All this talk, and for nothing. For nothing. So all of you, I talk to everyone, all of you the world over. Even just the people on Facebook or YouTube. On YouTube they don't really speak, a few people speak to me. On Facebook, people speak to me. They don't understand me. So, okay. So I will strive for those few people who appreciate where I'm coming from. On YouTube and Facebook. I will strive. I will sacrifice this humor. I don't care what anyone says. Oh no, don't sacrifice you. No. No, because for what? For what? For what? So that so many of you may think, oh, he's just a doofus, he doesn't need anybody and need any help. I need help in order to continue my mission. So sorry for that. For decades, me chanting all these mantras. Not hanging out with anyone, any particular Indian religion. Because I saw through most of their nonsense too. So now I'm going to all of a sudden jump on an ashram bus? No, no way. Forget about it. It's not happening. And, you know, you can judge me as you want. But just remember that when I say the words, Krishna, Shiva, Ma, or even when you hear me say Obatala or anything like that, it's not on the same level. I was born under the name Daniel. No one calls me that for decades. Narayan Shivaji. Just call me Shivaji. Not trying to be Hindu. Just me.